Welcome to the 2023 Farragut High School Score Choral Program, pre-JV Lyle concert. My name is Abigail Vaughn and I am a senior in the Advanced Mixed Choir. My fellow singers and I have been working very hard and are excited to prepare for show you everything that we've prepared tonight. To prepare for this evening, we are kindly asking that you silence all of your devices and make sure to refrain from flash photography. We hope you enjoy tonight's performance of the FHS Choral Program pre-JV Lyle concert. We now ask that you please rise for a combined performance of the Star Spangled Banner.
Thank you. 10th grade, and I'm in the men's chorale here. Our next song is I Loved You, and it is a sitting poem of A.S. Pushkin. Pushkin was born in 1799 and is considered one of Russia's greatest poets and founder of Russian modern literature. After being banished from the capital city of Moscow for his revolutionary writing, Pushkin turned his focus to writing some of the country's most beloved romantic poetry. This song speaks to the experience of both loved ones, loss, and regret, and ultimately finding peace. Although he passed away in 1836 at a young age of 37, this poem still holds a special place in the heart of his people. We hope you enjoy Jay Rose's arrangement of I Loved You.
I'm a sophomore in Women's Chorale. The final piece concert choir will be performing is Reuben and Rachel, arranged by Andrew Larson. This song was originally published in 1871 in Boston and is a comical ballad telling the story of two feuding lovers. Rachel laments that women should be better off if all men should be transported across the Northern Sea, while Reuben tries to convince her that everyone would be better off if the men stayed on this side of the Northern Sea. Many people refer to this piece as a folk song because new text is often added to the story. The one thing that has remained constant is the two Ralu Ralu refrain. Please enjoy Concert Choir's last piece, Reuben and Rachel.
That we don't normally do in a concert, but if you turn your program over to the next page, you'll see a series of pieces of music. Look at them. Look. They've got it. They know. Now, theoretically, well, not theoretically, you have had what you're looking at longer than they have had it. So what we're doing right now is a thing called sight reading. So sight reading is literally looking at a piece of music and being able to sing it at sight the first time you go through it. Music literacy is a big part of the program that we have here. I don't feel like it's enough to just teach them how to use their voice. I think that music is something that can be used your entire life. And if you know how to sight read, all of a sudden there's so much more of the world of music that becomes open to you. So what they're practicing now is sight reading. Our fantastic student teacher, Mr. McCarter, is going to lead them in this exercise. And I'm gonna kind of explain what it is. I kind of feel like Vanna White. And I kind of like it. So we'll unpack that later. So we're doing an event called JB Lyle. You see, I get real awkward when I get nervous. So my kids are like, yeah, we know, it's fine. So we're doing an event next week called JB Lyle. I'm sure you've heard of it. I'll explain a little bit more about what JB Lyle is. But a part of that is sight reading. So Mr. McCarter, I'm now starting the timer. Sound good? Okay. So I've given them 2 minutes. That is the requirement that we have at JB Lyle. They have 2 minutes to look at this piece of music, dissect everything that they see on the page, and then sing it right the very first time. Does it sound stressful? Yes. Is it stressful? Yes. But theoretically, we prepped them for this. So sight reading, again, is the ability to look at something you've never seen before and be able to sing it. So if you want to go ahead and give them their tonal center. You can sing your do if you want to. Will you sing a major scale for me, please? So what they just sang there was the solfege scale. If you've ever seen the little bit movie that has a female, that's where it came from. So we use a system called solfege here, which is a series of just neutral syllables that you can use to find approximate pitch for things. And so we sight read on solfege for now. Eventually we'll get to the point where they're just going to look at the page and be able to sing it correctly with the words that you have on there. But we use the solfege at first. So they got 2 minutes of silent practice to figure it out. They're using a system called audiation. Audiation is your ability to sing in your brain. And these kids are really talented because they can sing in their brain while Mr. Moore yaps his mouth off the entire time. But I still gotta explain what's going on here. So their job is to pay attention to not only the pitches, but to pay attention to the rhythm and the chord structure all at the same time. They've never heard these other parts. It's soprano, alto, tenor, and bass. So they have got to somehow figure that out in their brain from their first pitch and use the skills they've developed to get all the way through that. So we're coming up on about 5 seconds left. How you feeling up there? Feeling pretty good? Seeing a lot of shaking heads? That's encouraging. All right, Mr. McCarter, the time is up. Let's see how they do.
Thank you.
what sight reading is. So I promise you, they had not looked at that beforehand. We've had that hidden from them, and I hope you didn't share it with them, but that's what it is. So I hope that you were able to hear the piece of music from that. I do this specifically at this concert because it is a requirement at JB Lyle, and this is our pre-JB Lyle concert. And my thought about it is, if they can do it here in front of you, they can do it anywhere. So I think that they're going to be well prepared to do it at JB Lyle, folks. Very nice. Can you give one more round of applause? Next up tonight, we have the Advanced Mixed Choir. They'll be coming on the stage. Just a couple of things about the Advanced Mixed Choir. I'm very proud of the work they've been doing this semester. All of the choirs here at Farragut High School are semester-based. So we do have students that will come to us semester after semester, but like this concert choir has only existed for about a month and a half. This Advanced Mixed Choir only existed for about a month and a half. So we're very fortunate to have dedicated students who work very hard. For Advanced Mix, within that month and a half, this is their, what is this, third performance? Or fourth? Third. So they got this one, then they've got JB Lyle next week, and then the next week they have another performance, and then luckily we get to go on spring break, and then they have another performance at Carnegie Hall, and then they have another performance at the Tennessee Music Educator Association Professional Development Conference. And then they have another performance at the end of the semester. So we keep them busy here. But you'll hear tonight that all of our students are very dedicated musicians. And we're really lucky here at the Farragut community. So thank you for being here. We're going to get them up on the stage. We have like 18,000 of them. And then I'm just going to be quiet because, all right, here we go.
Hello, my name is Adam Hoyman. I am a junior in Advanced Mix, obviously, and our next song will be Gloria from Franz and Schubert's Mass in G. Schubert composed this piece in 1915 when he was only 18 years old, and the text translates to, Gloria be to the God on high and on earth, peace to men of goodwill. We praise thee, we bless thee, we adore thee, we glorify thee. We give thanks to thee for thy great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, Father, Almighty Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, who takest away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Receive our prayer, who sitteth at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only art the Most High, Holy Jesus Christ, with the Holy Ghost in the glory of God the Father. Amen. And the soloists are Margaret Walters and Skylar Switzer. Please enjoy Advanced Mixed First Piece, Gloria.
Gloria, Ave Maria. Hello, my name is Maggie Rains, and I am a junior in the Advanced Mixed Choir. Our next piece is Goodnight, Dear Heart by Dan Forrest. In early October 2008, the composer's brother and his wife found out that the four-month-old girl they were soon to adopt from Ethiopia was in the hospital. Unable to help her in any physical way, they prayed ceaselessly and made appeals to speed up the legal process in Ethiopia. Initially, she had made a turn for the better, but on October 13th, they received the news that she had died. To commemorate the life of the never-met-but-loved child, the composer set to music a poem from Mark Twain, which could be found in his hometown cemetery. Mark Twain wrote this poem when his own daughter died unexpectedly at the age of 24. The text reads, "Warm summer sun, shine kindly here. Warm southern wind, blow softly here. Green sod above, lie light, lie light. Good night, dear heart, good night, good night." Please enjoy Advanced Mixed performance of Good Night, Dear Heart.
Oh, My name is Lindsay Hockey, and I am a senior in advanced mix. The final piece we will perform is Measure Me Ska, composed by Elaine Hagenberg. This is an upbeat but challenging piece written in a simple meter but juxtaposed with triplet patterns. The text challenges the listener to explore the limits, or lack thereof, of their existence. Musical lines often paint the idea of swirling wind in the air, further challenging the singers to sing with more energy and freedom. Please enjoy Advanced Mix's final piece, Measure Me Ska.
Sky be my death, wind be my wind.
concert choir had to do it, they've got to do it too. We're going to do the sight reading for them. You'll find theirs on the back of the first one. While this is being handed out, I have to give a very special thank you to someone that we would not be able to do this without. He's a very selfless human being, always there when I need him at our beck and call. He is just one of the best musicians I've ever met, had the pleasure of working with. And he is sitting at the piano right now. His name is Mr. Mike Stallings. Could you please give him a big round of applause? It is not easy to do the things that he does, but he makes it look easy, and so we're just so thankful for that. I do want to mention, as we're passing this out, just a couple of things. We have some donation buckets that will be towards the back. If you feel so led to support the choral program tonight, we've asked for a lot of money this year for a lot of different reasons, and so I'm sure you're rolling your eyes, but I will never not advocate for these students and their best interests, so you better believe I'm asking for money again so we can do more and better and bigger things for them. So I want to remind you of that, and then I want to say a big thank you to the Farragut High School Education Foundation. They just told us yesterday that they approved our grant. We asked to get a stipend of money that would go and cover the remaining balances of all the students who still had money left to go to Carnegie Hall. That was $3,800. And so they completely wiped out everything that we had left to owe for that. So if you know somebody at the Education Foundation, please thank them, because they are doing things to make our lives better here. So I just wanted to make sure that I gave them a solid, solid shout out for that. All right. Last flat equals. Concert choir, last sharp equals. Very nice. You can flip it over, please. Like a sports announcer, but like this might be golf or something like that. You might be wondering, what are they doing with their hands? So those are called Kirwan hand signs. So I told you about solfege earlier. Solfege has a series of hand signs, almost like sign language, that you can use with it. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, and do. And within that, we have our chromatic solfege and hand signs. I'm not gonna tell you that right now. If you wanna learn about that, you can sign up for choir next semester. But that is what they're using there. That's just a way to kind of reiterate and feel better about pitch whenever you're singing it. Tactile learning is really great for some of us. We've got visual learners, audio learners, tactile learners, and then everything in between. So we've got all of that running the gamut here while we sight read, just to make sure that whoever learner they are, they're being fed by something. Is anybody telling us? We're 10 seconds? I like 10 seconds more than we're done. Yeah. Oh, okay. me again. We've got one final piece for you. We call ourselves the Farragut High School Choral Program, not the Farragut High School series of separate choirs that have nothing to do with each other. And so we always try to bring together all the different levels of music that we have. Music is a journey. If you are concerned about your level of music, that is okay. Because I'm a different musician than I was a week ago, much less years ago, and much less than what I'll be in 10 years or something like that. And we celebrate that here. Because all of our students are held to a high level and we want them to participate beyond. So we do things like this where all of the students come together and sing because that's kind of what music is at the root of it, a community involvement idea. So our final piece for tonight is called Bridge Over Troubled Water. It is conducted by Mr. Wyatt McCarter, who I have waited until now to introduce. He is our fantastic student teacher. He comes to us from Lee University. We've had him since January. And I asked the students just a couple of things about Mr. McCarter, just some ideas that they thought about him. Some of the words that they said were kind. Some of them were that he was, now I'm forgetting what words that they said. Skylar, what was it that you said? Sharp, and I took that to mean he dresses well, which he does, we're very proud of that, but sharp in terms of what he's capable of doing in the classroom. And folks, let me tell you, to be able to command a classroom the way that this young man does, to the level that he does, is no easy feat. You can't teach stuff like that. And so we have been blessed and honored to have Mr. Wyatt McCarter with us, and he ends his time with us next week. And we just have a small, small thank you for your time here. So. Now, there's a trick. I do believe, Mr. McCarter, if you press a button on there, it's gonna do something. His arm? Sorry you couldn't hear that. Mr. McCarter became very famous in the program for a warm-up he does where he goes, "Good morning!" And so every morning we got to hear that, and so the bear has a recording of our students going, "Good morning!" on it. So you'll never forget us. I'm sure you want to forget us, but you never will, Mr. McCarter. Folks, thank you so much for being here tonight. We are so blessed to have such talented people involved. We couldn't do it without you. But without further ado, there's one final song here for you tonight, Bridge Over Troubled Water. Our soloists are Joey Neiman and Olivia Squires, under the direction of Mr. Wyatt McCarter, the combined choirs of Farragut High School. Thank you.
I will carry you like a bridge.
next concert. Have a good night.